My name is François Margolin, Margolin in English. I'm French, I'm a director. I'm there for the film Jihadist that I direct with my friend Lemine Ould Salem, who is Mauritanian and journalist.
What does the movie show? What does it show an audience who has never seen what goes on among the thinking or the practice of jihadists, Islamists?
But it's about radical Islamists. It's not about all the Muslims, but radical Islamists, it's what is in the film, it's the proof that they are Muslims. They are, I'm sure they are Muslims. They are, it's one tendency in the Islam is not the majority of the Muslim, but it's a tendency in the film. I wanted to prove that they are not fools, they are not crazy people, not a psychiatric guy, not a lonely wolf, as we say in France. They are people, they are well organized, and there is an ideology of the Salafism who is very important. It's who exists since the beginning of Islam, who sometimes is in contradiction of the majority, sometimes is more important. So it's very important for me to show that it was an ideology, because I know these people since long time. I know these people since 25 years. I meet these people in Egypt. I meet these people in Afghanistan at the time of the Taliban, where I was. I make movies about them. I talk with them. I know what they have in the head, which type of thinking they have. Mm. And I wanted to show that to the audience, first in France, but also in the world, everywhere. The film was distributed on the TV in Iraq, in Kurdistan, in Tunisia, in different festivals, and now in America. And I think it's important to know that thing and to have debate about what is Islam, what is the different tendencies. There is a moderate Islam, if there is a radical Islam. I think it's a very important debate also for the Muslims, not only for French people, for Christians, for Jews, for Buddhists, I don't know. It's very important because it's radical Islam is growing. When I was in Afghanistan in 2000, 1 year before September 11, it was only in Afghanistan, in Pakistan, in some mosques in Europe or in West Africa. But now it's everywhere in the world. So everywhere, and especially in the Arab countries, it's a big influence. It's growing. It's a big influence. It's they make a lot of terror attacks. They have a lot of imams, a lot of mosques. So it's very important. And I think, for example, that Saudi, who is very close, the ideology of Saudi, who is Wahhabism, is very close from Salafism. Saudi has a big influence because Saudian people, they have a lot of money and a lot of petrol, and so they are very influential in the Western world. So I think it's very important to understand what they want, because they want something. They want to transform the future of the world. They want to convert the people. They want. So it's very important for me to tell that to the people they don't know. They don't imagine this type of things.
When did you make the film?
We start 4 years ago. We start at the beginning when Timbuktu on the north of Mali was occupied by the jihadists. And when they were very close to go to the capital, Bamako, within a town of 1 million of citizens. And at this time, we decide to go there because I know very well this part of the world. I was many times in Timbuktu before that. And my friend Lemine Ould Salem is Mauritanian, he's not very far from there. This family is Tuareg, and in Timbuktu they are also Tuareg. So we decide to go in this place because also they speak French, because it's an ex-French colony. So it's not so far from Paris, it's like 4.5 hours of with an airplane. So it was much more important than to go in Afghanistan, because for the French audience, the European audience, it was something close. And I think it was very important to see the life under the Salafist regime, because it was one of the first place. At this time, it was no ISIS in Iraq or Syria. It was very important for me to show the life under the Salafist regime. What are the change for the people in the concrete life? What is the change for the music? What is the change for to smoke cigarettes? What is the change for education? What is the change for medicine? What is the change for everything? Because Salafists, they want to have rules for everything in the life of the people. There are rules for everything. It's not only for alcohol or for music. It's for everything in the life. They want to change the life, they want the return to the rules of the Islam from the beginning. Islam of Mahomet, Salaf, it's a return to the roots.
Mm-hmm. Yes. Now, these are the practices of Hamas, for example, in the Palestinian government. They don't permit music. They don't permit women to be open and modern. This is something that is throughout Muslim communities, even in the West. Is it being taught in mosques throughout the West?
Hamas is a little different because it's Muslim Brothers. Hamas is very close from the Muslim Brothers. It's financed by Qatar, who finance the Muslim Brothers everywhere in the world. Hamas, it's a light version of Salafism. It's a If you know the resurrection of the Salafism in the 50 years ago, it was coming from the Muslim Brothers. It was coming from the repression from Nasser against the Muslim Brothers in Egypt. And some of these guys were more radical and create the new Salafism and the jihadism. So it's not very different, but Muslim Brothers try to conciliate the radical Islam with the society, the modern society. And sometimes they are very radical, sometimes they are a little more tolerant with the people. But as we saw in Egypt very recently, they are not so tolerant also, it's like a percentage of radicalism. Excuse me for my English, it's difficult to explain, but it's a light version of Salafism.
Are there Muslims in the West who are following this ideology?
Yes, a lot. A lot, because I think in the Arab world is not all the Muslims, it's 25% of the Muslims in the world. In the Arab world, I think the influence of the Salafists is like between 15 and 20%. There is no statistic, but it's something like that. And I think it's the same in France, in the suburbs of Paris, of Toulouse, of Marseille, of Lyon. It's quite the same. It's very difficult in France to know exactly what is the influence, because there's something called taqiya. Taqiya is like a dissimulation of the thing. So people don't say really what they are thinking, but the influence is very important. It's absolutely not the majority. The majority of Muslims in France are not like that. But it's growing, and it's very influential for the young people. Young people coming from the immigration, and who are now different than their parents. They are French now. And these people, they are, yes, there is a lot. They are influenced by that. They are influenced when they are in jail, because they find solution in jail with imam who are a little radical. Yes, there's a lot of influence in Europe, and especially in France and in Belgium, because in France, in Belgium, it's the Muslims are coming from the Arab world. It's not the same than in England, where they are coming from India, Pakistan, or Bangladesh. It's not the same than in Germany, where the people are coming from Turkey. They are coming from the Arab world, and it's very different. And in the Arab world, there is a different mentality, and also the Salafists use the fact that France was colonialist in West Africa and in Maghreb. So they use this type of thing to say, yes, you have to revenge your parents. So they use that to have a big influence in France.
Where has the picture been seen on television in Europe?
Nowhere for the moment. In Europe, nowhere. It was shown in festivals. It was shown in movie theater in France, on different countries. But no, it was not shown on the TV, because the interdiction of the TV was in France was a problem with other European TV. Yes. Yes.